is a valuable important lesson. What is inside atom? What is inside atom? What is inside an atom actually? So now generally we observe that suppose if you take any object, you can make the object into smaller pieces, smaller and tiny pieces. Okay, so now let us have a piece of chalk. So go on making into smaller particles. So while you are making, use to observe at last stage you will observe a tiny particle, small particle, which cannot be visible to our eye. We cannot see almost that much smallest particle. So now the scientist used to name it as atom. The scientist used to name a smallest particle, a smallest substance, is nothing but an atom. But earlier stages, the scientist thought that the atom cannot be divisible. Now what is the meaning of divisible? So it cannot be divided into further subparticles. But here, this is observed till the John Dalton's atomic theory. So up to the time, the people and the scientists observed that the atom is indivisible. But later what happened? So when you are going to observe the electrolysis experiment of Michael Faraday. Michael Faraday is a scientist. He conducted some of the experiments based on the electrolysis. So then he observed that there is a negative charged particles. There is a presence of negatively charged particles. So now till Dalton, what we thought? So an atom is a neutral one. It has no charge. And we understood that this is not divisible for the subatoms. But because of the Michael Faraday experiments, so we can understand and we are going to expect that there is a division of particles because of the appearance of negatively charged particles because of electrolysis experiment. Okay, so now based on this criteria, the scientists go on doing some experiments. Okay, so the first experiment did based on the negatively charged particles, that is, he is none other than Thomson. So Thomson, because of the Thomson, he discovered the electrons. So now, why it is called electron? Because he named them as electrons, which are negatively charged particles, having a very, very, very little or a minute, a finite mass. And it has negative charge. Okay, so Thomson, the first subatomic particle which is discovered, that is electron. Electron is the first discovered subatomic particle. So what is the meaning of subatomic? So inside the atom, the particles are called subatomic particles. Okay, so later, after electrons, so which is a generally we can understand, if there is a plus 5, then if the total value is 0, then the meaning is there is a minus 1. Okay, suppose when you add two things, when you add two values, the total value is 0. What is the meaning? So there is a negative and there is a positive. Here also, so the atom is having no charge. What is the meaning of no charge or a neutral atom? So because of the electrons, there should be presence of a positively charged particles. So they are named as protons. So protons are the charge of opposite charge to the electrons, but equal in magnitude. So the value of the charge is equal but opposite to the electron. But it is heavier than electron. So the mass of the proton is almost all 1836 times of electrons. Okay? So now from that concept we can understand that protons also there inside the atom. So because of electrically neutrality, a word, electrically neutrality, the meaning of electrically neutrality nothing but because of the negative charges, there is a presence of positive charges. So like that, the number of positive charges is equal to number of electrically negative charges. So the net charge is becoming zero. So scientists thought that earlier there are only two charges. Positively charged particles called protons, negatively charged particles called electrons. But later, James thought Chadwick. So because of the experiments going on, so developing different experiments, so he found out a neutrally charged particle called neutron. So neutron is a particle, a subatomic particle, which is electrically neutral. It has no charge. So that is why we can understand that there is a positive charged particles, negative charged particles, electrically neutral charged particles. Nothing but it has no charge. So they are called, what you call them? They are neutrons. So from this fundamental concepts of subatomic particles, we can say that there are electrons, protons and neutrons. Okay, so later we are going to understand how the subatomic particles are arranged inside the atom. So they are nothing but different atomic models. So we will see in the next class, so what are the different theories or what are the different atomic models. Okay, thank you.